Joseph. My partner. My friend.
Sebastian, calling back so soon, what's up?
After all this time, there's something we've never talked about.
Sounds ominous. What is it?
Not what. Who? Joseph.
Right. I know that you respected Joseph and that he felt the same way towards you.
I never had the opportunity to make amends about that. Things were confusing after Beacon. I should have tried to get answers about what happened. I mean, I know what happened. Don't worry, I can't fault you for what you did. But I still blame myself for his death.
You don't have to do that, Sebastian.
Why not? You'd prefer that I blame you? You're the one who actually killed him.
No, I didn't.
I saw you shoot him, Kidman.
I know you did, but...
But what?
Joseph isn't dead.
What? Are you... No. It can't... What happened to him? Where is he?
That's a long story. And a conversation for another time. When we're both safe. Just know that you don't have to blame yourself for his death anymore. I've gotta go, Sebastian. Let's finish this and we can talk later.
Yeah. You bet we're gonna talk later.
Kidman, what did you just say to us? Joseph is still alive. You didn't kill him in the events of the Evil Within 1. Well, we actually kind of know that because of the DLC. But Sebastian doesn't know that, so this is very genuine emotional repression that we totally haven't not have to tell in for 3 years because we already knew because of the DLC, but Sebastian doesn't know. Well, fuck you, Kidman. Okay, so Joseph is still around, guys. Joseph is still around. And I'm really glad to hear about this because honestly, we did get to see in the DLCs that he was being carried away. What Mobius was going to use him for, of course, we do not know. And so this video's main purpose will be to gloss over the possible theories of Joseph's eventual final fate. That sounds like a movie. But let's get right into this as always, anyway.
She killed him.
No, I didn't.
I saw you shoot him, Kidman.
I know you did, but...
But what?
Joseph isn't dead.
What? Are you... No. It can't... What happened to him? Where is he?
That's a long story. And a conversation for another time. When we're both safe. Just know that you don't have to blame yourself for his death anymore. I've gotta go, Sebastian. Let's finish this and we can talk later.
Yeah. You bet we're gonna talk later.
Now, if you combine this piece of dialogue and the original DLC's revelation, Joseph was brought outside of STEM and evacuated to somewhere unknown. The implication was that Joseph was going to be used for a specific task or project, or Mobius would have executed him right off the bat instead of taking him somewhere else. Now, we know Mobius has some very powerful brainwashing, technological advancements, as well as power and influence over individuals. It's not actually that far of a stretch to consider two possibilities. Joseph was going to be implemented into the new STEM system with his memories rewritten, or Joseph was going to be used as a new core, even possibly a temporary backup, or maybe just an agent overall. Now, considering Kidman knows a lot of information about Mobius and she seems to play a central role in it, as well as Myra and Theodore being executive members as well, it's not too much of a stretch they may have hatched a plan to attempt to rescue Joseph in this situation, but we'll just have to find out because Kidman did say we'll have a conversation about this later. Looking at the cutscene that happens after the final chapter, and there's going to be major spoilers here, guys. After exiting STEM, Sebastian and Kidman do go their separate ways, with Sebastian taking Lily away, and Kidman decides to stay on her own for unknown reasons. It doesn't seem in this situation that Sebastian actually cares much about Joseph, and it is understandable now that he has to take care of Lily and after everything that just transpired. However, Kidman does still seem to have some kind of strong resolve, like she's got some kind of agenda or goal to still do, and I would say that rescuing Joseph if he's still in some kind of dangerous situation, maybe in a different STEM environment. It could be a whole new test environment they were using between the events of Evil Within 1 and 2 as 3 whole years have passed. And so this is one of the possibilities, that Joseph is still in danger and Kidman intends to rescue him from it. Now another possibility is the fact that Kidman and Myra could have rescued him between the events of the Evil Within 1 and 2 and got him away from Morbius's control. Now the reason I don't think this is likely is the fact that Morbius didn't seem to be suspicious of anybody working as a double agent or even a Splinter Cell group within the organization, so the likelihood of this to me is quite low, but if it is a thing, they could still do this as DLC and it could just work as a prequel and give us additional information about the events of the Evil Within 2. It's also known that the long-term consequences and effects on the mind of being in STEM are not known, and with Joseph being an extensive research subject, it is possible that Mobius are actually using him to try to get a further understanding on that very topic. However this goes, I know that Joseph was a very popular character from The Evil Within 1, and a lot of people were quite disappointed to not actually see him in The Evil Within 2, or not even properly referenced except for this slide that not even everybody saw. So I think the chance of a DLC occurring around Joseph are quite high, and if you consider all of the possibilities on his eventual fate with everything we know, it is prime material for a good story DLC, and it could either be in the real world or STEM itself. Going either way works perfectly. It would also help establish more of Kidman and Myra's character, and it would give us closure on the entire subject, so this is the perfect material. I want to know what you guys think about that, and I really hope the Evil Within 2 team do consider these DLC projects, as I really think they could add to the game that is already amazing. And if anyone's wondering my personal thoughts, by the way, on The Evil Within 2, that it's basically a 9 out of 10 game. It's absolutely excellent. I have very little criticisms for it. I overly praise it in most aspects, and I just really want to see DLC. That's the only complaint I really have that's really getting on my nerves, is there's no confirmed DLC, so I really just hope the base game isn't all we get, and I'm sure you guys think that too. Just let me know what you think in the comments below, guys, and I hope this video has been informative and entertaining as always. But we shall see if these two original characters, Sebastian and Kidman, get any future DLCs at all. I mean, both characters, they could have many opportunities. They're both very original, beautiful characters. Have a beautiful day as always, guys. Take it easy. And peace.